Hello and welcome to another episode of Jack in the Sky Kingdom. Wait for it to load out here. I thought I'd give you guys a little taste of the opening. Adventures of Lady Amara.
Look at that, an unexpected guest. How very rude, Detective, to come without an invitation.
How rude not to give me one. Must be the prince Emma mentioned. I should follow him. Yeah, absolutely. Great idea.
Thank you.
Sky King go from respect or conceit? This casket he holds looks familiar. Oh, poor kitty. I wish you that's what you're looking for.
Know what you're trying to do, Detective. Why work so hard against the inevitable?
Oh, does he keep disappearing like that? If you are in a city floating on a cloud, and you want to know how he keeps disappearing like that, that kind of looks like a condom. I'm sorry, but it does. It looks like a clear condom. Of course I'm not going to pick any up or anything. Oh, I guess he's making magic. So those are probably normal ones.
Why do you care so much about such worthless people? Humans are cruel, sin-ridden beings.
Yep.
They carry out horrible atrocities every day, without a thought to their victims.
Yep. And again, so are you. So, pot calling the kettle black. Oh, there's the flower. Is that for the sand? Adventures of Lady Emma, 2 of 4.
Creatures. Surely you see they are beyond help.
Yeah, but see, I'm watching.
Join us, Detective. We will cleanse the world of its evil and remake it in the glorious image of my father. Will be better off. We can create the ultimate utopia. Stop wasting your time, Detective. Embrace the purge and accept your fate.
How about no? I was just thinking the same thing. I've never been one to simply accept fates. Me neither. Thank you. that's what we need to put on the door. Observatory telescope has he been studying the stars? First. This would be more suited for a sculpture. Oh, for crying out loud. Can't blame me for trying. Oh, I hate this one. I always have to cheat and use the guide, but I'm gonna try not to.
Say I didn't warn you.
Surprise! Thought I was done for, didn't you? I was lucky.
I
managed to grab onto a branch before I hit the ground.
Oh,
it slowed my fall and landed on the beanstalk. Good thing you fixed the aircraft earlier. Otherwise, I couldn't have made it back up here. You saw Emma? How is she? Detective, I'm going to look for Emma. You should try to find the navigation room. If we can just move the Sky Kingdom towards a deserted area, the town will be safe.
Yeah. I'm moving right along. I just did chapter, let's see, 1 and 2, and then this was 3 and 4 in just 21 minutes. That's crazy. I saw that. Magnetic compass. I'm assuming so. And chapter 6 already. Okay. We need a cello tuner in case I get bored.
Do you remember this face, Detective? One of your more well-known cases, I believe. I know everything about you, Detective. Your every thought, every move you'll make.
Right. question to ask us.
Detective, that's a portrait of Emma. She must be around here somewhere. I have to find her.
So you're just gonna stand here and let me find her is what you mean? What are you? Golden Springs. Oh, maybe for the shallow that I need to use that into. Okay, let's get the princess her tiara. This must be Emma's Red Riding Hood. The badge looks different than the one in Jack's cottage. The Underdark Prince likes both a disguise and a crown. Oh, he needs a crown too. Thank you.
The story begins with a noble-born lady named Emma. Unsatisfied with her mundane lifestyle, she rebelled against her family and trained under the Order of the Red Riding Hood Sisters. Oh. During patrols, Emma saved a young man by the name of Jack, a fortune hunter with a charming smile and tales of adventure. They fell in love, and she left the sisters for a future with him. Jack had a dream as well, in the form of the elusive kingdom in the sky and the heist of a lifetime. But all his research fell to naught until Emma gave him the magic beans that had been in her family's possession for generations, a secret heirloom connected to the kingdom.
And yet the only reason she gave them to him is because he was being a whiny bitch.
But the kingdom proved to be as treacherous as it was bountiful. Emma found herself abandoned by the man she loved, and at the mercy of the king and three princes of the kingdom.
I wonder the princes, are trying to kill us all.
Unexpectedly, the king claimed Emma as his descendant, proven by her possession of the magic beans. He treated her like a daughter, but Emma soon realized the king had been bewitched to set upon a nefarious path that would destroy the world. Emma knew she would need help to stop the king. She sabotaged the floating kingdom, exposing its location, and hoped it would alert the attention of the fairy tale detective before the island's destruction went too far.
Detective, that's a portrait of Emma.
I know that.
She must be around it.
Thank you.
Detective, that's a portrait of Emma.
Thank you.
Great job, Detective. You got the bolide shard. Hand me the Queen's ring. I'll help you open the box.
No, Detective. He's an imposter. He's trying to trick you.
I've heard rumors that Prince Julian is a shapeshifter. That's a handy trick for fooling people, isn't it? I'm sure you can tell that I'm the real Jack, can't you, Detective?
Give me the ring.
I never got that before.
What have you done to Emma, you coward? Show us your real face.
At last, the Queen's ring. Thank you, Detective. What would we do without you? When your miscreant little friend stole off with the ring, we thought it was gone forever. Now the power of the shard can be unleashed, and the world will be a blank canvas for us to paint over.
Quick, head to the castle. Go!
Alright, I'm gonna cut it short there. Especially since we're right at almost 59 minutes. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It is coming to a close now. So a lot of chapters all in one go. But anyways, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. See you on the flip side.